अस्सलाम वालेकुम फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू दिस मैटलैब ट्यूटोरियल। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू हाउ टू डिज़ाइन सोलर पीवी अरेज इन सीरीज एंड पैरेलल कॉन्फ़िगरेशन इन मैटलैब सिमुलिंक सॉफ्टवेयर। फ्रेंड्स, बिफोर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन अबाउट द सीरीज एंड पैरेलल कॉन्फ़िगरेशन, फर्स्ट लुक एट द टेबल विच शोज़ द रेटिंग ऑफ 200 वाट सोलर पीवी अरे। It may be noted that maximum voltage and current for this 200 watt solar PV array are 26.4 volt and 7.58 ampere respectively. Now let's consider a case in which two solar PV arrays are added in series. Both have the rating of 200 watt, having the same voltage and current as mentioned in the table. In this case, we know that in series connection, voltages are added whereas current remains same. Therefore, when two solar PV arrays having voltage of 26.4 volt are added, their total voltage will become 52.8 volt as shown here, whereas current remains same having value 7.58 ampere as shown here. Furthermore, we know that the power is equal to the product of voltage and current. Therefore, when two solar PV arrays of 200 watts are added in series, it will provide the total power of 400.224 watt as shown here. Let's verify it in the MATLAB Simulink software. Look at the model which shows the basic solar PV array having power rating of 200 watt. Friends, on this model, I have already made a video with title on how to design 200 watt solar module in MATLAB Simulink software. Therefore, I would like to strongly suggest you to watch this video first for understanding the basics of this model. Now double click on this solar array. You can see it asks to put the number of parallel strings and number of series connected modules per string. Therefore, keep the parallel strings as 1, whereas right here 2, as we are adding 2 solar modules in series. Keep the other settings as shown here and press OK. Now we have to put the resistor value for this condition. We know that when 2 solar PV arrays are added in series, then their resistance value will become 6.96 ohm as shown here. Therefore, come to model again, double click on this resistor block, put here resistor value of 6.96 ohm and press OK. Now you can run the simulation by clicking on this play button. You can see it has successfully measured the voltage, current and power for this case. Now compare the results with the mathematical calculated values. You can see all the results are correct. Now let's consider another case in which two solar PV arrays are added in parallel. In that case, we know that in parallel configuration, currents are added whereas voltage remains same. Therefore, when two solar PV arrays having current of 7.58 ampere are added, their total current will become 15.16 ampere as shown here. Whereas voltage remains the same having value 26.4 volt as shown here. Furthermore, we know that the power is equal to the product of voltage and current. Therefore, when two solar PV arrays of 200 watts are added in parallel, it will provide the total power of 400.224 watt as shown here. Friends, it means that whether solar PV arrays are added in series or parallel, power rating remains same. However, there exists change in voltage and currents only. Let's verify it in the MATLAB Simulink software again. Now double click on this solar array. In the parallel strings section, right here 2, as we are adding 2 solar modules in parallel. Whereas in the number of series modules, right here 1. Keep the other settings as it is and press OK. Now you can run the simulation by clicking on this play button. You can see it gives error. It is because we have not changed the resistance value according to this configuration. That's why it is giving error. It may be noted that when two solar PV arrays are added in parallel, then their resistance value will become 1.74 ohm as shown here. Therefore, come to model again, double click on this resistor block, put here resistor value of 1.74 ohm and press OK. Now you can run the simulation by clicking on this play button. You can see it has successfully measured the voltage, current and power for this case. Now compare the results with the mathematical calculated values. You can see all the results are correct. Now let's consider another complicated case in which two solar PV arrays are added in series and two solar PV arrays are added in parallel. Now in this case, both series and parallel configurations are added. Therefore, due to series configuration, voltages are added, which results in total voltage of 52.8 volt as shown here. Similarly, due to parallel configuration, currents will also be added, which results in the total current of 15.16 ampere as shown here. Now the total power, which is equal to the product of voltage and current, will become 800.448 watts as shown here. Let's verify it in the MATLAB Simulink software again. Now double click on this solar array. In the parallel string section, write here 2 as we are adding 2 solar modules in parallel. Whereas in the number of series module, write here 2 again as we are adding 2 solar modules in series. Keep the other setting as it is and press OK. Now we have to put the resistor value for this condition. We know that when two solar PV arrays are added in series and two solar PV arrays are added in parallel, then their resistance value will become 3.48 ohm as shown here. Therefore, come to model again, double click on this resistor block, put here resistor value of 3.48 and press OK. Now you can run the simulation by clicking on this play button. You can see it has successfully measured the voltage, current and power for this case. Now compare the results with the mathematical calculated values. You can see all the results are correct. Now let's consider the last case for large solar system in which 10 solar PV arrays are added in series and 40 solar PV arrays are added in parallel. Now in this case, both series and parallel configurations are added. Therefore, due to series configuration, voltages are added, which results in the total voltage of 264 volt as shown here. Similarly, due to the parallel configurations, current will also be added, which results in the total current of 303.2 ampere as shown here. Now the total power, which is equal to the product of voltage and current, will become 80.8 kilowatt as shown here. Let's verify it in the MATLAB Simulink software again. Double click on this solar array. In the parallel string section, write here 40 as we are adding 40 solar modules in parallel. Whereas in the number of series modules, write here 10 as we are adding 10 solar modules in series. Keep the other setting as it is and press OK. Now we have to put the resistor value for this condition. The resistance value for this large complicated configuration is 0.871 ohm as shown here. Therefore, come to model again, double click on this resistor block, put here resistor value of 0.871 ohm and press OK. Now you can run the simulation by clicking on this play button. You can see it has successfully measured the voltage, current and power for this case. Now compare the results with the mathematical calculated values. You can see all the results are correct. Friends, by following the same strategy, any solar PV array from small size to large size can be designed in the MATLAB Simulink software. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.